Morning, beautiful people. This is Brad from the beach. Still got my white hat on and looking forward to just sharing with you guys about the bread that has come down from heaven. His name is Jesus. Yesterday, we looked at the first chapter of Mark's gospel and we read verse 14 out of that. I want us to go now from 14 into verses 15. And then the first part of 16, because I want us to know where this leads. But in verse 15, it simply says, this is Jesus now coming on the scene after John the Baptist had been put into prison. And he says, the time has come, he said. The kingdom of God has come near, or the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe the good news. Now, what does it mean the kingdom of God is at hand? The kingdom is where the king rules and reigns. That's where the kingdom is. And Jesus said, we don't need to look here or there for the kingdom, but the kingdom of God is within us. So the degree to which we allow Jesus to rule and reign in our lives, in our finances, in our relationships, in our moral behavior, in our thinking, the degree to which we allow him to rule and reign, that's the degree to which we experience kingdom life. And the degree to which we submit to that in our lives, it positions us to release kingdom life in the world where we go. Now, here are a couple of things from this that I want to leave with you. When he not only says the kingdom has come, the kingdom is near, the kingdom is within you, he says repent. Repent and believe the good news. The repentance here, as I read this, the thing we need to repent from is our need to be in charge, our need to be in control. One of the last areas of rebellion in our lives is that we seem to have this right to ourselves, right to what we want, right to who we are. When the truth of the matter is, when we make Jesus Lord of our lives, He is Lord of our lives. He's in charge of our lives. We've surrendered our rights to Him. That way we become related intimately and we get to see the kingdom manifested. And the other thing he says here is that we need to believe the good news. The word believe here is a word that means to rely upon, be committed to submit yourself to. In other words, we don't just give lip service to the gospel message or to Jesus, but we invest in that through believing, relying upon, and really submitting ourselves to the reality of who He is. And what's the good news? The good news is Jesus. The good news is Jesus. And wherever we are, whatever's going on, the good news in that moment is Jesus. The world may throw all kinds of bad news to us, but baby, Jesus is the good news. He died for you. He died for me. He's here right now, moving amongst us. He is coming for His bride. There is that day when we will be with the Father for all eternity. Good news is Jesus. All He is, all He came to do, all that He's done. The cross is a finished work. Salvation is available right now. And if you, by faith, will repent of your need to be in charge of yourself and submit your life to Jesus and believe on Him for His finished work on the cross, you will be born from above and become a child of the Most High God. This has been Bread from the Beach. Have a great day.